thumb injuries, metacarpophalangeal joint ligament ruptures, also known as gamekeepers or skier's thumb. So this is a video of continuing injuries specific to the thumb. Last one was about the first CMC joint. Now we're talking about the metacarpophalangeal joint. A little story. During a Brazilian jiu-jitsu competition in the gi, one of the athletes attempts a throw. She grabs her opponent's belt over the back to secure a Georgian grip with her thumb in the belt. However, at the same time, her opponent drops down and lunges forward, going after her legs. Unfortunately, her thumb remains entangled within the belt and causes it to bend backwards and hyperextend. There's pain, she's unable to use the thumb, and, well, there's a problem. Another example, MMA fighter with open gloves in a scramble moving around gets shoved into the fence and his thumb gets stuck inside. And in trying to avoid getting taken down, his thumb gets pulled backwards and it hurts. This video is about the fairly common injury to our thumb involving a ligament being torn at the metacarpophalangeal joint. It has been given names such as gamekeeper's thumb or skier's thumb, but it is also fairly common in combat sports. Any activity that can jerk your thumb outwards and backwards subjects your thumb to this injury. To reiterate from other videos, the importance of the thumb to our daily functions cannot be understated. When our thumbs do not work, especially as a post to pinch against or grip against, we really notice. We're going to talk about the anatomy involved, how the injuries happen, and how we treat these injuries. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board-certified orthopedic surgeon and specialist in the hand. Please like and share and subscribe. So first, the anatomy. The thumb is unique to all other digits for a lot of reasons. First, it is in a different position. It functions on a different plane than the other fingers. Also, it has very unique anatomy compared to the other fingers. Its first CMC joint, which we talked about previously, allows for a lot of motion compared to the other CMC joints. Additionally, while the other fingers have three phalangeal bones, the little bones that make up the fingers, the thumb only has two. Due to these differences, the thumb is the incredible digit that we pinch against, that we grasp and hold things. It allows us to use tools and have a precision grip, a strong grasp, all this because of our thumbs. It is the pinch function that we lose with the injury talked about in this video. To be able to have a strong pinch, the thumb metacarpophalangeal joint, also known as MCP joint, the joint connects the metacarpal to the phalanx. It must be able to be stiff. The ligament that supports this joint the most with pinch is the ulnar collateral ligament, or the UCL. If the ligament is not working, the joint will gap open, which often hurts, and also makes the action of pinching and grasping weaker. Now the injury, how does this happen? Anything that deviates the thumb to the side, away from the hand, can stress the UCL ligament of the MCP joint. This is often possible when the thumb is away from the hand in the first place, outstretched, abducted, which happens in almost every sport. The injury classically occurs with falls and people trying to catch themselves, but holding ski poles while crashing can be the culprit, hence skier's thumb. Historically, Scottish gamekeepers who would break rabbit necks between their thumb and index finger would, over time, wear the ligament down, causing it to rupture. Hence, gamekeeper's thumb. I've seen this injury many times in combat sports, whether it was during a punch with MMA gloves and the thumb getting yanked backwards. On a side note, this injury used to be more common in boxing, when the old gloves would have the thumb as an independent part of the glove. But now, the boxing gloves, the thumb inside there, it's much less common in boxing. This injury also commonly happens when people's thumbs get tangled up in things, and that certainly happens with the gi in jiu-jitsu or judo or sambo. So, with the thumb being pulled away from the hand and deviated to the side, the UCL will rupture with enough force. Usually, it pulls off the bone from the phalanx side, and sometimes it can be associated with a fracture of the bone. Sometimes, the thumb is bent to the side so far that the ligament not only pulls off the bone, but it also ends up on top of other soft tissues, preventing it from going back to where it needs to go. It can't heal. This creates a bump at the side of the thumb called a Stenner lesion, and it's something that a doctor may be able to feel to make the diagnosis. The ligament on the other side of the joint, the radial collateral ligament, is injured much less frequently than the ulnar collateral ligament, and it often does not require surgical treatment. Sometimes it does. So, you hurt your thumb. How do you make the diagnosis? It will start with getting x-rays. This can help you look for a broken bone. Sometimes there's subtle hints that the joint is falling off to the side. An exam is going to be very important. Sometimes, though, getting the exam is difficult because it hurts. But the doctor will try to stress that ligament to see if there's excessive gapping, and they can always compare it to the other side. Sometimes these exams can take place with the help of ultrasound or under x-ray, gapping the joint open, and can really appreciate the fact that the ligament is not working. An MRI is, we'll say, the gold standard study. The MRI is the test that will really let you see the soft tissues the best. Treatment. If the ligament is only partially torn, then surgery will not be needed. It's a bad sprain, and often is just treated with some splinting and rest for about a month. However, if there's a big fracture of the bone, or if the ligament is completely torn, especially if it's found its way above the soft tissues and it can't heal, surgery will be necessary. The surgery involves opening the area up, locating the ligament, and putting it back to where it needs to go. But then you have to hold it there with sutures and or special suture anchors. Sometimes the surgeon may use a suture to actually act as the ligament temporarily, and this gives the initial process a little head start in allowing for range of motion and activities as the repair is fairly protected. Now the recovery. It takes 6 weeks for the ligament to heal back to the bone. During that time, the thumb is protected. The surgeons who use the suture to temporarily act as the ligament may start range of motion and other activities before this 6 week mark. After 6 weeks, there are usually no restrictions, but the thumb is stiff and weak. This is when hand therapy becomes very important. It will take many months to regain strength and range of motion. This is another one of those situations where I tell patients that I hope that they are using their thumb normally at 3 months from surgery, but they may still notice some improvement in strength and range of motion and discomfort for even up to 1 year after surgery. Hopefully, you have found this video useful. If you've enjoyed it, again, please like, share, subscribe. As always, I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, encouraging you all to keep moving and to take care of your body so it takes care of you.